a dead, exciting addition to the Blood Bowl range, to face the Wolfenberg Cripsdealers on the Astrogranite is a grave mistake. Welcome to this painting video, where we're going to show you how to paint a zombie lineman from the Wolfenberg Cripsdealers team. Now, while we're painting a zombie in this video, many of the techniques we're going to show you here will work on other players in the team as well. So grab your paint, your brushes, and your brains, and let's get started. So, to prepare our model for painting, we've already undercoated it here with Chaos Black Spray. Once that's dry, it's time to start painting our zombie. And the first area we're going to look at is our zombie's rotten flesh. Now, for this miniature, we're going to start off with a base coat of Rakarth Flesh. And then over the top of that, we'll apply another base coat of Cadian Flesh Tone. First of all, it's that Rakarth Flesh. For this, grab your medium layer brush. Let's grab some paint from the pot and apply it to our palette like so. Now we're using a palette here, so we're going to add a bit of water from our pot just to mix it in and thin that Rakarth flesh down, just to make sure it goes onto the model really smoothly. Load the brush up and then onto our zombie lineman. Here we're applying a nice even base coat of Rakarth flesh all over the skin like so. Now you may see, as it's going on over the top of a Chaos Black undercoat, that it may need a couple of coats to get a nice solid base coat. Not a problem at all, let the first coat dry, then go onto a second one over the top. Here, as you're applying your base coat, try and be as neat as you possibly can, but at this stage, don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back later on and paint over it. Then, over the top of this, we're applying a base coat of Cadian Flesh Tone, again, all over the skin. Now again, here we thin this down with a touch of water to make sure it goes on really smooth. The reason we put the Rakarth flesh on in the first place was to make sure this colour would be nice and solid over a black undercoat. So it's important to get both of these colours base coated on. Just make sure you're taking your time to be as neat as you possibly can. There we go, that's a nice solid base coat on our zombie's flesh. Now let's shade it down next using a Thonian Camo shade to make it look really rotten. Once that's done, we'll highlight it up first with Kislev flesh and then with Flayed One flesh. First of all, is that the Thonian Camo shade, and for this we're using our medium shade brush. Let's grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now what we're going to do here is add a touch of water into the wash, just to help thin it down, so when it goes on it's not quite as strong as it is straight out of the pot. There we go, just a little bit of water, that's perfect. Then we're going to load the brush up, and now onto our zombie. We're applying a nice even coat of Thonian Camo shade here all over the flesh like so. Now you can apply this as heavily as you like. I'm going to apply quite a thin coat here, but if you want it to look even more rotten, you can apply more heavily or even two layers, or even use it straight out of the pot. Okay, once that wash has dried, now we're going to be applying a layer of Kislev flesh over the top of the skin like this. We've thinned it down with a touch of water to make sure it goes on really light and smooth. And now it's applying a layer over the raised areas of the flesh. With that done, we've got some Flayed One flesh. We've thinned it down with a touch of water, and now we're applying our highlights to the edges of the muscles on our zombie. So nice thin highlights like this, nice and subtle as we thinned it down, just being applied all over the edges of the muscles. There we go, that's our rotten flesh highlighted. Up next, let's provide a red glaze on certain parts of the skin to make it look like it's beaten and raw. And for this, we'll be using Caribou Crimson Shade mixed with Larmian Medium. Grab your small airbrush for this one. First of all, let's take some Larmian Medium from our pot onto our palette. I'm going to take about two brushfuls here, two big brushfuls. Perfect. Then wash the brush off, make sure there's no medium left on there at all, before taking about half a brushful of Caribou Crimson and mixing it into the mix there, creating a sort of really thin down Caribou Crimson. Then take a little bit of paint on the brush like so, and it's onto the zombie. Here we're applying it in certain areas we want to look a bit beaten. So for example, around the top of the head here, it's got a lesion there, we'll paint a little bit there. I'm also going to paint it into the eyes and around the mouth to make it look like blood's coming from our zombie's mouth. There we go, and around the eyes as well to make them look dead and sunken. And other areas of the skin, you want to make it look like it's been stretched or raw, maybe here around where it meets the armour. This is entirely to your taste, do it wherever you like on the skin, but don't apply it too heavily or in too many places, you don't want the skin to be red after all. So there we go, that's our dead zombie flesh complete. Okay, up next, let's have a look at painting that black and orange striped top of the Wolfenberg Cripsdealers. Now we're going to start off by painting the orange stripes onto our zombie first using Jacaro Orange. We'll then base coat over the top of that with Troll Slayer Orange. Then we'll tidy up the black areas using a Baden black before highlighting the orange areas with Luggernath orange. First of all is that Jacquero orange. For this, grab your small airbrush. Now here we're going to take a little bit of paint from the pot like so, and again onto our palette here. We're going to thin this paint down just a bit to make sure it's going on real smooth. We also want a nice point on the brush as well. Just make sure we've got a nice point going on there on the palette. Perfect. Then onto our zombie. Now what we're going to be doing here is drawing stripes onto our zombie's jersey. So what we're going to be doing is just drawing up from the bottom here and just drawing up to the top like this. Oh, drawing a stripe like that onto the jersey like this. We're going to go around and draw stripes like this all the way around in equal partitions like this, all the way around the zombie's jersey. And once we've done that, we'll fill in those orange areas, leaving the black areas black. With those lines filled in, now it's time to go over the orange again with Troll Slayer Orange to get a nice solid base coat. With that done, we've now got a Baden black out, and here we're going to be cutting back into the orange sections on the jersey to make sure all the lines are even and the lines are straight. So just very carefully painting lines up like so, just to make sure it's nice and even all the way around the jersey. As we have this paint out, we're also going to go and give a base coat of Baden black to the armor panels and the cloth on our zombie's legs as well. With the black tidied up, now we've got Luggernath orange, and we're applying a highlight to the orange sections of the jersey. So here we're just applying a nice thin line highlight around the very edges like so, also up the edges where the stripes meet the black like this. Just a nice thin highlight using a small layer brush. There we go, that's the orange highlighted. All right, up next, let's highlight up the black cloth. This will be the black stripes on the jersey and also our zombie's trousers too. We're going to start off with a highlight of Eschen Grey being applied over that Baden black we've already applied earlier on. Once that highlight's done, we'll then use another highlight, this time of Dawnstone, and then finally we're going to pick out the stitch on the front of the jersey with Rakarth Flesh. First of all is that Eschen Grey, and again for this, grab your small airbrush. Just grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette, and here again, to make sure this goes on nice and subtle and smooth, we're going to thin it down with a touch of water and make sure we've got a nice thin point on our brush. There we go. Then onto the zombie. Here we're applying this highlight onto the black parts of the cloth. So we'll start off here on the trousers down here, just picking out those higher bits there and the raised areas at the very edges like this, all around the black cloth on the zombie. And don't forget as well to pick out the black areas on the jersey too. So that's going to be the edges of the cloth on the jersey, even around areas like this small little hole in the jersey there, and then the raised bits, and also the edges of the stripes too. Next up, we've got Dawnstone, and here we're applying as a second highlight over the top of the Eschen Grey, but this time just the very sharpest edges of the black areas, so like the edges of the jersey and the edges of the trousers, for example. With that done, now we're picking out the stitch on the front of the zombie's jersey here with Rakarth Flesh. Just a really tiny amount there, just be super careful. There we go with that, that's the jersey done. You can also see we've painted the same scheme onto those stripy socks as well. Alright, up next let's paint that weird green armour of the Wolfenberg Crypt Stealers. Now for this we've already base coated the armour with Abaddon Black, and after that we're going to highlight the armour up with Cabalite Green, followed by another highlight of Cyberite Green. First of all, Cabalite Green, and for this we're using our small layer brush. Let's take some Cabalite Green from the pot and onto our palette. Again, we're going to thin it down with a touch of water as we want this to go on real smooth and thin and subtle. Then we're just making sure we've got a nice amount on the brush, then onto our zombie. Here we're applying this as a line highlight around the edges of the armour. So here we're just picking out the very edges like so, around all the armour like this. Just taking our time to be as neat as we can around the armour panels like this. Now when this dries, it will dry really subtle, but that's absolutely perfect. That's what we're after. Next up, we've got Cyberite Green, and here we're providing a really thin edge highlight along the edges of all the armour panels, making sure we're leaving a little bit of the Cabalite Green still showing through. There we go, that's the armour done. Okay, up next, let's grab some Dryad Bark and apply it onto various parts of the miniature, namely the wood, rope, and leather. For this, grab your small airbrush again. Let's take some Dryad Bark from the pot onto our palette. Again, we're going to be adding a little bit of water from our pot here just to make sure it's thinned down and it goes on real smooth. Perfect. Then, onto our miniature. Here we're applying this dryad bark onto various parts of the miniature. So we've got the wood down here on the leg. Don't forget to paint the top of the wood here as well. We've also got the rope going around the waist here as well. And various parts of leather on the model too. So the boots we've got down here, and also other leather straps we've got as well, such as this one under the arm here. So there we go, that's the dryad bark base coated onto all those areas. All right, let's start painting those details in. Now I'm going to start by painting the wood by dry brushing it first with Terminator Stone, followed by a wash of Seraphim Sepia. Then we'll highlight the leather with XV88, the boots with Gorthor Brown, and finally the ropes with Xandri Dust. First of all, it's that Terminator Stone dry brush, and as this is very small detail, we're actually using a medium base brush for this. Let's grab some paint from our Terminator Stone pot here, and onto a piece of tissue paper, brush off most of the paint like so, like this, get rid of all that paint, work it in, bingo, you want almost no paint left on the brush. Then, onto our zombie. Here, we're dry brushing this very carefully against the grain of the wood, onto the wooden parts of the model. So that wood on the leg there, for example, just going to dry brush it on there, and we'll also hit the bits in here as well. Now make sure as you're doing this, you're not hitting other parts of the model. If you can possibly avoid it, be as neat as you can. If you do, go back afterwards and tidy it up with dryad bark. Then over the top of this dry brush, we're now applying some Seraphim Sepia as a wash to make it look like wood. Up next, we've got XV88 and our small layer brush. And here we're going to be applying a thin highlight to the leather straps all over our zombie. Next up, we're highlighting the boots here with Gorthor Brown and again using our small layer brush. Next up, we're going to highlight the rope by picking out the individual strands with Xandri Dust like this. Using a small layer brush here and taking our time and being nice and neat just to pick out the individual strands of rope like so. When it gets to the bunch of rope in the middle of the zombie here, you can just use the edge of your brush and pass it over the rope like so, making sure it just picks out the raised areas. There we go, that's the rope painted. Okay, there's one more detail we're going to paint on our zombie lineman. That's those metal caps on his boots, and we're going to paint them in a dark metallic colour. We'll start off with a base coat of Balthazar Gold, then we'll dry brush over the top with Sycorax Bronze. First of all, that base coat of Balthazar Gold, and for this, as it's such a small detail, we're going to be using our small layer brush again. Let's grab some Balthazar Gold from the pot and onto our palette. As always with the base paint, a little cheeky touch of water just to help thin it down. Perfect. Then onto our zombie. Here we're going to be picking out those metallic areas. So here we're going to be painting out the caps of the boots here on both sides. There's also a small piece of metal here as well on this wooden leg, which we're going to be painting around at the same time as well. Just pick that out now. Then over the top of this, we're dry brushing Sycorax Bronze onto those areas. Here I'm using an old medium layer brush to get a bit more control on this dry brush. Once I've dry brushed onto the bigger areas like the toe caps, I'll then take a small layer brush and highlight carefully the small bit of metal on the leg. So there we go, that's the metal painted and our zombie just about finished. But of course there's one thing left to do on this miniature, and that's to provide a textured base to make it look like he's playing on some Astro Granite. Now there's lots of different textures you can apply onto your miniature, but for this one we'll be using Agrellum Badland. Once that's on and it's dry, we'll then wash it with Agrax Earthshade before dry brushing it with Terminator Stone. And once we've done that, we'll finally add a pitch line on using Corax White. But first of all, is that Agrellum Badland, and of course for this we're using our trusty Citadel texture tool. Let's grab some paint from the pot onto the thick end of the texture tool like so. Load it up like that. Perfect. Then onto our zombie. Here we're applying this onto the base of our miniature like this, applying it on top as so and then spreading it around much like icing on a cake. Crucially, you can use this paint to fill that big gap on the base in the middle there. But whatever you do, don't fill this hole here, as that's used to carry the ball in a game of Blood Bowl. Spread this around the base all over, and when you get near the feet of the miniature, you can use the thin end of the texture tool here for a bit of added control. Spread it all over the base, allow about an hour for it to fully dry, and once it has, we'll move on to the next stage. Next up, we're adding a liberal coat of Agrax Earthshade over the top of this using our medium shade brush. Next up, it's a cheeky dry brush of Terminator Stone over the top of the base. Here, be super careful when you're getting near the model's feet. Make sure you don't brush Terminator Stone all over his shoes. Up next, as a bit of an optional extra, we're going to draw a line on our base with Korax White to make it look like our zombie lineman is actually on a Blood Bowl pitch. Here, our Korax White has been thinned down quite a bit with water. Using a medium layer brush, just draw a straight line across the base like so. There we go, perfect. There we go, that's a cool Blood Bowl pitch line drawn on our base. All right, but last thing we're going to be doing here is adding some tufts onto our base for a bit of extra texture. These are Middenland tufts, and when they come, they arrive on a plastic backing sheet like this. To remove them and apply them, simply grab your fine detail cutters. Let's take one of the tufts from the backing here, like so with the fine detail cutters, then onto our base. We're applying this gently onto the base like so. They're self-adhesive, so just press them down like this, and they'll stick right in place. Apply as many as you like onto the base. I'm going to add a couple here. And once that's done, we'll paint the rim of the base with Steel Legion Drab. So there we go. With the tufts applied and the base rim painted, our base is finished. And there we go. With that, our Wolfenberg Crypt Stealer's zombie lineman is ready for the Blood Bowl pitch. And just like that, you can get your Wolfenberg Crypt Stealers painted in no time at all. Couple of things to remember here. First of all, when you're applying your base coats, shades, layers and highlights, try and be as neat as you possibly can. But don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back later on and correct them. Second of all, when you're painting the orange stripes onto that jersey, try and be as neat as you can with the lines and then go back with the black and tidy them all up. Try and make sure those lines are about as equal as you possibly can. Hope you've enjoyed the video, sports fans. Happy painting.